Mark, what are you going for? Last chance trade time.
Yeah, so we're going with Blackstone here. So Blackstone is the largest private asset manager in the world. And when you look at stock valuations, when you look at bond yields right now, it really makes sense to consider alternatives in your portfolio. So individual investors over the course of the last several years have begun to throw away their old 60-40 strategy of 60% stocks, 40% bonds in favor of more of a 50-30-20 strategy where they're allocating about 20% towards alternatives. And when you look at endowments, so institutions, right? So from 2002 to 2018, equity exposure has gone from 50% all the way down to 36%. Fixed income exposure has gone from 23% down to 8%. Alternatives have gone from 24% all the way up to 53%. So money continues to flow into these alternatives. There's fee compression across the entire asset management industry, but it's not hitting alt managers. And this thing's paying a 3.6% dividend.
So the pushback, I guess, would be, could all of that now change to affect this industry, whether it's the fees come down, the fact the stock price has already had a fantastic run in the last 6 to 12 months, the fact that private market valuations to which this is geared are high, real estate valuations to which this is also geared already high?
Yeah, I mean, there certainly could be some sort of mean reversion, but I do expect money to continue to flow into these asset classes, right? I mean, you have to look at the cost of capital, right? And where is the best place for you to allocate it right now? Is it in stocks, which might be trading at an 18.5 forward multiple? Is it in bonds that are paying a 1.8% yield, right? So I still think there's more value in these private asset managers.